Generally, the reasons for collapses of buildings in Lagos Island are generally one, a lot of buildings on the island are old, they are under very little maintenance, they are very close to each other. Generally, there's lack of political will to open renewal on Lagos Island. You have structural issues. For instance, good materials for construction on Lagos Island only go in during only go in at night because of the dense, you know, activities, population, and then also activities of area boys. Construction on the island rarely get any form of, you know, proper supervision from government agencies that are supposed to oversee the construction and make sure that they are done properly. We also have the issues of very bad plumbing. So you have water leaking into the buildings, and then water destroys everything. The reinforcement bars that are supposed to hold concrete together deteriorate inside, not visible to the eye, and over time they just, you know, unravel, and then the building collapses. Well, an integrity test says that the concrete, really, the concrete and the reinforcement, that you check if they are still of load bearing capacity. When a building is being built, for instance, they carry out what you call cube test. The concrete that is going to be used to cast a particular area, you pour into a cube that you take to the lab for a cube test to check the strength of that concrete. If it doesn't meet the requirements, then there's disaster ahead. The real solution is increasing the capacity of government agencies to carry out their functions. Then people who will carry out these functions need to be put in place. We don't have the good competencies are lacking across board. And then integrity of the people who are carrying out these activities. There's, you know, economic disadvantages all over the place, and people are willing to make all kinds of compromises and write reports that are not true. But then it now goes back to, do people get punished? The people who supervise all these projects, who signed up on this project, now that it has collapsed, are we going to find out who signed up on this project, and are they going to get sent, are they going to be prosecuted for these things? Because when these things don't happen, then, you know, once there's no recourse, everybody does everything at the length, because nobody's going to get punished.